Peace be upon you. Today we are going to have a look at LibreOffice Impress Remote. Now, for those who don't know, this is a new functionality that the LibreOffice team has added to the LibreOffice Impress application, so that you can use your Android device, your Android cell phone, your Android tablet. I don't know about the tablet, but on mobile it's working nicely. So this is it. You have to go to the Google Play Store and then get this application from there. As you can see, I have installed it on my cell phone. So here's my cell phone and it is installed on it. First thing that you would have to do is you would have to install LibreOffice 4.0. So I'll put the download link to it in the application in the description below. Again, LibreOffice 4.0 is required. So if you have LibreOffice 3.6, you would want to upgrade yourself because it will not work on previous versions. LibreOffice 4.0.1 is required. For Ubuntu users, I'll give the PPA that has the latest LibreOffice, the stable PPA. So don't worry for that. The next thing that you'd want to do is you would have to start LibreOffice Impress. Okay, so here it is. Don't worry why the buttons are not on the whole screens. I don't know why, but it's not a big deal. It's something on Netron only, on KDE specific. Not sure about that also. So you go to Tools, and then you go to Options. Okay, here. Then in Options, you go to LibreOffice Impress, and then General. See here, Enable Remote Control. You would have to check that, and OK, and then Exit. So you have to exit it, and I also say that you can log out and log back in just in case. So before we go on any further, what you have to do is, and this will work on Linux, Mac and Windows as per the LibreOffice team. I only use Linux, so I've only tried it on Linux. So what you have to do is you have to enable your Bluetooth on your cell, and then as you can see, I have my Bluetooth, my cell phone paired with my desktop. You have to get that pairing done. Again, how I'm using a Bluetooth on my desktop, I have a Bluetooth dongle that has been very faithful for me for quite a time and works really well with Linux. So you have to do the pairing then. And then the thing that I told you have to get the LibreOffice remote control thing working. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, now we are going to launch presentation file. Now I made this presentation file for a place where I was teaching English, so it is good. I made a good presentation. So, and now you can see I have the application LibreOffice Impress Remote installed. If you can see over here, clearly icon is there. Click, and then you launch it. Again, you see, as I have already used my desktop with it, it's showing Kamil's desktop. If you can see it, so I'll go and click on that, and it says over here, start a presentation. Now what is required is that you have a LibreOffice presentation running, because if it is not running, it will not connect and it will not work properly. So what would be required is that you have a LibreOffice presentation running. So now I'm going to start up the presentation. As you can see, is the start of the presentation over here. I'm going to start it. And there you go, it's working nicely, you can see. Now you can use the volume rocker to change the slides, as you can see over here. Let me get myself over here and show it to you. Okay, you see I'm also over here, no problem. So as you can see, I'm using the volume rocker to change the slides. Nicely done. Again, there is another feature. If you go click over here, the icons that's over here, click over here and you get a grid view of the presentation. So for example, if I want to go to this slide, I click over there and I go to that slide. As simple as that. Again, if I want a simple layout, I get the simple layout. And it's scrolling also. So if I scroll over here, you see it's scrolling nicely. Again, this is a very low-end phone, so the high-end phone will work pretty much properly. Again, let's show the range. But it's a Bluetooth, so it will work nicely. As you can see, the slides are moving nicely. One more option is there that you can let me show it to you. It has a blank screen option. So when I click on the blank screen, it will show the blank screen. So when in a presentation, for example, you are demoing something or talking about something and you want the attention of the users, so you can just do blank screen and then that will be there. Again, you can return to slide. There is the option. There are certain options over here. If you click and go to the options, you can enable volume switching, that is the through the volume rocker you can work on that. And then enable wireless is that required if you want to enable it to get it working through a Wi-Fi, because it also has a option to get it working through the Wi-Fi. Bluetooth works for me, so I use that only. So excellent application, really like it, really useful. See, working nicely. So I hope you like that, and thanks for watching. I'll put the necessary links in the description below. Peace be upon you.